fan of this weekend's hometown Maine, we head to Turner. This is a town that has close to 6,000 people and is just a few minutes removed from the Twin Cities of Lewiston-Auburn. The town is also home to some great waterways, a state park, and even has its own private airport. And it just may be the vintage snowmobile capital of the entire world. Let's head now to Turner for this weekend's hometown Maine. The town of Turner has that nice countryside feel, but with all the amenities of a larger city. Route 4 will get you to just about any place you need to go in town. Drive down that road a few miles and you're going to come upon this building, which just so happens to be the home of one of the most impressive collections of antique snowmobiles in the entire world, with just about every make, shape, and size dating all the way back to the 1950s.
And they all run. This is a 65 Polaris.
This right here is the very first twin-cylinder race sled from Polaris in 1968, 600cc. This one here I've kept because it was one of the hottest models to find. It's a 74 Skidoo Blizzard.
This is the United Sports Antique and Vintage Snowmobile Museum, where Paul Bernier has close to 200 vintage machines.
This is a 72 Auto Ski Mach, three-cylinder. This was the sled I would have traded just about anything for it.
And now you have it.
Now I have it.
It's a collection Bernier kind of stumbled upon when he was a snowmobile dealer back in the 1980s. He started collecting trade-ins and then stored them in a chicken barn.
I sold the business, went up to the barn, and found that there was well over 100 sleds up there, and I was going to grow and build a new building, so I decided to build a museum.
From there, Bernier made yearly trips out west to the largest snowmobile swamp in the world, bringing back up to 20 sleds annually over a 15-year period.
And as the word got around, people donated some, people would call, and the museum grew and grew, and we had shows here yearly.
Is this the oldest?
This one right now is the oldest. It's got a Wisconsin engine. A lot of these engines were generator motors.
And by the way, his oldest sled dates back to 1959.
Only six of these were ever made?
Yes. A gentleman's still alive. I've got the documentation and the paperwork from Skidoo.
Bernier says half the fun is finding and restoring them. The other half, of course, is riding them.
My plan is to try to drive every one of them. So every year I get two or three running, and we go riding.
And there was a time when Bernier would race a couple of his sleds in the town's annual One Lunger vintage snowmobile race. One Lunger, of course, meaning one cylinder. He says it's a great race for the town and showcases vintage machines, but he's now happy just being a spectator.
So you've got to be really in shape, because some of those holes were this deep, you know, by the time they were going, and you know, seats were going this way and hoods are going that way.
Bernier has yet another collection at a nearby annex, where he can just pick and choose what to ride and then go sledding. And how many times do you get a chance to rev up the engine and ride a classic like a 1973 John Deere?
The love of the sport is what keeps me going. The collecting is kind of almost secondary.
And if there's something about your hometown that makes your hometown unique, person, place, or thing, we, of course, want to hear from you. Email us at hometownme@wmtw.com, and maybe we'll feature your hometown in a future Hometown Maine segment. All right.